We're here at NAMM 2018 in Anaheim, and we've been waiting. George and I have been talking about a product, but you might be familiar with the Centrance Micport Pro, which a lot of you are probably still using because they're a great product. But we're talking with Michael Goodman. Michael, the president of Centrance, and they have a new product that we've been waiting for the rollout for some time, the Mixerface. Tell us about it.
Yeah, thank you for stopping by, Dan. We're very excited to have you here. We love our supporters in the voiceover community. We love the work you guys do, and obviously we're always envious in how you can speak and how we can't speak. this product right here, Mixerface R4, is our newest member of the mobile recording interface family. What this product does is it connects to a phone, and it turns your phone into a mobile recording studio, so a DAW essentially, right? If I pick a phone here, you can connect the Mixerface to a phone. They're about the same size. And then now, if you have a DAW or some kind of software on the phone, like for example, Twisted Wave, which I know is used a lot, or some other software, you can do all of your recording on the phone and post-processing on the phone. This is what's different from a typical situation when you use a recording interface and you record to a computer. Or even if you use a location recorder, of which there's many different models, what you have to do with a location recorder is you have to take out the SD card at the end of the session, move it into a computer, then open up a post-production session, and it takes a lot of time. It's not ideal. So this allows you to do everything in essentially one session, because you can record to the phone, you can do all of your editing, all your post-processing, and send that recording off to FTP or email, etc. Right? And if essentially you're done. You can finish post-processing in the back of the cab, we're saying, you know, on the way back from the gig, and you're done. This thing is very lightweight. It connects to Android phones, iPhones, computers, Mac and Windows, right? It has an 8-hour battery. I will turn it off here. You just push this button. Very similar to some of our other products. This is your battery indicator. So it shows you how much battery is still left. And then it's got two high-quality mic frees with high-Z inputs and a high-pass filter in case you're doing an interview maybe outside and there's some wind noise that you need to cut out.
We use that a lot.
Right. So these mic frees are very low noise, low distortion. There's two controls. These are essentially zero latency monitoring controls, which is not available on the Micport Pro, but so many people were asking for them. We added them in. This lets you adjust the balance of your own voice or the sound that's coming back from the computer. So if you're narrating to a music bed or some pre-existing track, this allows you to balance how much of that or how much of
yourself.
Skype session.
Yeah, exactly. You want to hear less of them, more of you.
Exactly. This is inputs 3 and 4, which is also amazing for some music applications, but also perhaps for voiceover. You can feed a second stereo track into this thing and essentially narrate over that as well. So you can create a little monitor mix for yourself. Headphone output, line level output, and most importantly, built-in recorder.
Whoa. Runs on a disc.
There's a micro SD card that you put in, and then this recorder records in the WAV file at 1648, which is perfect for most work that you do out there. So you can actually record to two places. You can record to an iPhone or iPad, a computer, etc., and you can in parallel create a backup safety copy inside of this machine, right?
Nice.
Does it also act as a USB interface?
It does act as a USB interface. So when you record to the phone, you're using the USB interface portion of it, but at the same time, there's a second tape machine. I'm going to use the old term, right? That's inside there.
It's a backup.
It's a backup, yeah. Exactly. It's a fail-safe recording mechanism. Yeah. We also have a third recording mechanism in a way of an analog output jack, so you can record to camera if you're doing some camera work, right?
Sure.
And then you can technically print three different mixes, which is amazing, right?
That is.
Price point on something like this?
We're currently thinking of a price point of retail price of $299 without the recorder. There's going to be a model without the recorder in case you just want to print to the phone.
That's great.
And then the recorder will add about $50.
Amazing.
We're also looking at a couple of XY microphones that we're going to be announcing as well. Those are prototypes yet. And they will add another $50 to the price of the product. Depending on the kind of customer, somebody may want that, somebody may not want that. I think most of the voiceover customers will still want to use this like they use the Micport Pro, meaning a short cable and a professional microphone that defines your sound. I think that's going to be the most popular use case.
I think the backup recording feature in there is super valuable for people that do audiobooks or really long form. I get an email every couple of weeks. I hit stop on my DAW or whatever, and I lost my track. Or I had clicks and pops because my hard drive. If that was recording in the background, you'd save a huge amount of frustration being able to have that backup recording.
Thank you. We believe that, you know, people are people. People make mistakes. This gives you peace of mind. And I would appreciate if I was doing a session and I had a backup track.
Absolutely. Congratulations.
Thank you very much, George.
We're very happy to see this finally.
All right. Yes. Looking forward to shipping a whole bunch of these very soon.
How soon is it coming out?
About 2 months.
Two months.
All righty. Thanks for being with us.
Thank you very much, Dan.
Thanks, Michael.
Thank you for having me.